Hello everyone. Today let me introduce to you the new UNI-T UT15B Max. This is my only other UNI-T multimeter, the other one being the UNI-T UT191T Pro that I acquired 4 years ago. I got interested in the 15B Max when I read about it and I thought that the manufacturer may be onto something here. This is what I get from the boxed package. The main unit, two sets of test leads, a cloth bag with Chinese documentation. This model is so new that the English user's manual isn't available yet, even on their website. The included user's manual here is in Chinese. Although it may not be apparent in the video and photos, the UNI-T 15B Max is actually wider and taller than the UNI-T 191T Pro by a few millimeters. And in terms of size again, comparing it with the Fluke 107, it completely dwarfs the smaller digital multimeter in terms of size. They offer this in a new series, the other two models being the 17B Max and 18B Max. The main differences that I can see are that the 17B Max can measure temperature, while the 18B Max can test for both temperature and LED via a dedicated tester. The 15B Max has neither of those. However, the 18B Max doesn't have this min-max button that the 15B Max and 17B Max have. Reason number one, the 15B Max gives off an audible and visual warning. This happens when you mistakenly select the wrong function with respect to the input connection. For example, here I selected voltage with the black test lead connected in the common terminal. I inserted the red test lead in the A input terminal. Both the hold and select buttons flashed and it emits a constant beeping. Another instance, I selected current measurement in the 10 ampere range, but my red test lead is inserted in the microampere range. Again, the visual and audible warning. It alerts the user to stop and check first for proper connection. Yet, a serious user error can still occur. For example, the instrument doesn't give off a warning in this instance because the function selected correctly corresponds with the right input connections for current measurement. But if I forget about this and place the test leads in a voltage source, for example in this outlet, what would happen is that a short circuit fault will occur. The multimeter will become a low impedance jumper between L1 and L2 of this 230 volt outlet. And this is where the input protection of the 15B Max comes into play. And that's the second reason why I got the 15B Max. There are two 1000 volt high-speed, high-interrupting capacity busman fuses that protect the current inputs of the 15B Max. As you can see, there is a separate fuse for the 10 ampere range input and the microampere slash milliampere range. One is rated at 11 amperes, while the other one is rated at 440 milliamperes. They looked legit, and they are quite expensive. I keep a few of them myself as spares for my digital multimeter. If I'm not mistaken, they are rated at 20,000 ampere interrupting capacity. Third reason, the 15B Max gets its own dedicated backlight button, which is most convenient. One of my pet peeves among clamp meters and digital multimeters were backlight control being nested together with the hold button and short backlight duration. Not the 15B Max. There is a solo function backlight button here, and not only that, you get two levels of brightness as well. This is a feature I think you will find only in high-end digital multimeters. The light stays on for 2 minutes, which isn't bad at all. Reason number four, two sets of test leads come as part of the purchase. Both pairs have gold-plated tips. One is called the standard tip, this one, while the other is fine tip, much more pointed. They use number 18 AWG wires sheathed in flexible material and at 1.4 meters long from elbow to tip. They are longer than most test leads that come as standard accessories when you purchase other digital multimeters. I apologize for skipping the current measurement here, since I rarely ever use this, but I will test for the millivolt AC to measure current using the compatible AC clamp accessory called the UNI-T UT-CS06A, and this will work to measure large current because of its output ratio of 1 millivolt per ampere. This is a perfect match for the UNI-T UT15B Max. the 15B Max is powered by two 1.5 volt AA batteries, so you can use disposable batteries or rechargeable batteries. Personally, I prefer rechargeable batteries because they are leak resistant. Besides the four main reasons I mentioned above, I also like the layout of the instrument. The rotary selector makes an assured click into position. The screen is large and well lit with its backlight in dim locations. The characters are so bold, I think they can be seen from the moon. Visibility is good from 90 degrees on top, at the bottom, and on the sides. It's only when you view it at an angle from the top that they are washed out. The labeling work here is top-notch. Sharp and neat. They did this quite well. There are no invisible red lettering, no invisible full black function selector. You have here a clearly marked indicator arrow. The operational buttons catch on quickly and don't feel mushy at all. The rubber cladding here provide a good protection for the meter. There is a keeper for the test leads, as well as, I think, a provision for hanging strap in this part here. Now for the things that I do not like. The back stand or the tilt stand of the meter is quite loose. It comes down on its own. I like the one on the 191T Pro a lot better. This has a distinct detent position and it clips into place and does not fall off. Getting to the fuse of the UNI-T UT15B Max is not a walk in the park. You need to remove the rubber cladding and the six screws to uncover the back of the meter. Then you have to be very careful in putting them back, because although the screws are metal, they are embedded in plastic, which can easily lose its threading. And of course, it does not come with an English user's manual. It's also not available from their website at this time. I think that the new UNI-T UT15B Max offered something significant that can be appreciated by users. Let me know what you think in the comments below. If you would kindly hit that like and subscribe buttons, I would appreciate it very much. Thank you for watching. Stay safe.